What's going on, guys? Cornice here. In this quick video, I want to share with you really how to generate leads online. I had a question earlier, a couple days ago actually, and I'm making this video now. But the question was, how do you like generate leads online, I think, and what is the real difference between generating a lead and simply getting a like on your Facebook page or making a connection on Twitter? And I'm going to show you the difference. So here's my blog, and this is going to be a quick example of my blog and how I use my blog to generate leads. Let me refresh the screen here. But when someone goes to my blog and clicks to read a blog post, or actually when they just come to my blog, this pop-up comes up right here, and this is used with AWeber. AWeber is an email marketing company, and I can create this nice little form. It says this stuff here, and then it gives them the chance to enter their email. Now if they do that and they sign up, they're gonna subscribe to my list, and I generated a lead. You could also go down and click on one of these banners, maybe like this one's pretty popular, the Attraction Marketing Bootcamp, and then if you click on the banner, it brings you to a capture page, and they can enter their email and opt into my list. Another way, you know, is with Twitter, and this is the inside of my direct messages. I'm just on twitter.com, clicking on my messages, direct messages that people have messaged me privately or personally. Here's a quick example. I automate this message. He responds. I ask him if he's trying to learn Twitter marketing. Let's say he responds yes, and then I say, okay, cool, I have a free bootcamp on Twitter, or I have a free Facebook group. Would you like to be a part of it? Now, here's the difference. If I send him my free Twitter training bootcamp opt-in lead magnet, he can enter his email and opt in and subscribe to my list. Now, that's generating a lead. I could send him to join my Facebook group, where I don't technically gather his personal information, other than I'm connected to him inside a Facebook group where I can easily access it and get in contact with him. However, I wouldn't consider that generating a lead technically. I would consider that making a valuable personal connection online. And they're both extremely valuable, and it's up to you how you want to go about building your business. I recommend doing both. I recommend learning about both and how you can really position yourself to serve your audience. Here's another quick example before I end this video. This is my YouTube channel. You can see I have a banner, call to action. You know, it can lead these people to go to cordice.com to type it into their browser if they're interested, or they can click this right here, and this brings them to my blog, which they could opt in as a lead on my blog. But let's say someone finds one of my videos. Here's a quick example of a video that I somewhat ranked online. I ranked it the first couple months, but I don't think it's getting as much traffic as it used to. But here's my Jeunesse Vima YouTube video, and you can see it's got 502 views, which it's not too bad, I guess, for just kind of throwing something together here. But when they watch the video and then I tell them to click the link below, it gives them the chance to go to cordice.com, and they can click that and they can opt in, or they can click the blog post. So those are ways to generate leads online. This is Cornice. If you guys have questions about generating leads or how to do it specifically with Twitter, because that's what I really specialize in, that I'm best with Twitter for myself personally. I'm not the best at Twitter in the world or anything, but I'm good at Twitter for generating leads and making a lot of connections and growing a big following. So if you guys have questions about this, drop me a comment below this video, or just comment on the Facebook post and get in contact with me, and we'll go from there. All right, guys, have a good night. Talk to you later. Bye.